All right, what we got here is a SRT Neon. SRT4, we installed a Hotchkiss rear sway bar kit that we got used. We installed new bushings on here, changed the grease fittings, but this is the important part here. See this? The links that came with the bar, they were very short. They came up to here. The problem was that it was actually interfering with the brake line. And you couldn't go this way because then the head of the sway bar link was hitting this. So I don't know what model came off of or what year, but this is what we use. Look at this. This is a link from a Ford F-150. We had to drill the bar out a little bit to about a 5/8 hole. And it makes this angle this way and then this way. Because what happened is that that bar lines up exactly even with this hole. So you couldn't put any, the factory links, of course, was this way and the bar was flat. So you were able to put like a link straight across. But since this Hotchkiss bar is flat this way, you have to have something that goes that way. So we've got this Ford link. It's got the nice length. Makes this angle this way, goes this way. Doesn't touch the wheel, doesn't touch the body or any of the pipes here. It actually comes out nice because the bar actually comes out even. Okay, it's pretty much straight. Because I think if it was the other way, pointing down with the short one, this bar would have been a little cocked. So, the bushings came from Hotchkiss, from Jegs. This is the little rebuild kit that we got from it. And the links came from AutoZone. We bought the Value Craft ones just in case we had to mess with them and grind them, but they worked out pretty good. All right, I'm gonna show you back again on the other side. All right, that's the Hotchkiss bar. There it is, that's the way it looks like right there. I mean, you wanna get crazy and drill a little even bigger, you can. You know, you're gonna go past that point, but then I didn't want that thing to stick out too far past the wheel. So that's good right there, it's nice and tight. It's not going anywhere. See, it's got plenty of clearance with the BC Racing coilovers, and it's not touching any of the brakes, the brake lines or anything. All right, that's it. Looks good. Ciao. Thank you for Steve's help.